Yo, what's up guys? You got Pokiame here with another Pokemon Sword and Shield video. Obviously, I have that Sword and Shield fever because we just got our Direct today. Now, I want to talk a little bit about Wooloo and a little bit about how this Pokemon can be potentially good slash great and competitive. This is a lot of theory mining. Obviously, you guys can give me your thoughts on what I have to say. And if you don't like this, let me know. If you do like this type of video, let me know as well. And I'll do it for the rest of the Pokemon throughout the week. But I basically wanted to talk about how this Pokemon, as I mentioned, can be good or great in competitive if it's, you know, if certain conditions are met and a little bit based on what we know. So this is a normal type Pokemon and it has the ability Fluffy. That's going to be its competitive ability, right? Runaway, unless it has some sort of boost like or buff like Shed Shell this generation, it's not going to be anything good for the in competitive. So Fluffy will be the ability you guys use. And as you guys know, Fluffy halves damage taken from contact moves, and it also makes fire type moves super effective against you, or 2x damage, right? So, in order for a Pokemon to be good, one of two conditions needs to be met, right? They have to be exceptional at what they do, and for the case of normal types, I'll give the example of Chansey, right? Chansey has no offensive presence at all, but it's still an excellent Pokemon because of the Violite item, because of the fact that it is an easy stealth rocker, and it's an all-around fantastic special wall, right? And honestly, with, you know, this type of HP and defense investment with an Aviolite, this Pokemon is as bulky as a Swampert, right? So it is a fantastic wall. A lot of people don't like it. Has reliable recovery and soft boiled. You guys by now should know how Chansey works. For those that don't, this is like a standard set on Chansey, right? This allows Chansey to beat pretty much every special attacker out there, unless they go out of the way to do something for Chansey. But that's a standard Chansey set, and yeah, that's what they do. Maybe this also works as well. But so that's one of the conditions that needs to be met. Another condition that actually goes alongside that is that the meta allows them to be good. So let's take Snorlax, for example, right? Snorlax is a very solid Pokemon, right? All around, in VGC, it's fantastic, or it was at certain points, because of Belly Drum and Curse and I have Papa Berry and Gluttony and the super citrus berries like Figgy and all that stuff being boosted, right? Has great HP, great attack, great special defense, can curse up to boost its defense, but it's not in singles, it's RU, and that's only because the meta doesn't allow this Pokemon to currently be good in the OU tier, right? I'm talking in terms of OU, by the way. When I talk about great, I'm talking about these Pokemon being OU. I want to be a little bit more clear about that. For those of you who don't know what I'm talking about Smogon tier and whatnot. Stick around if you still care to listen. But basically, Snorlax is a fantastic Pokemon, but the current OU metagame does not allow it to be good. Not only can it not use moves like Rest because of Tapu Koko and Tapu Fini's ability, but there is a plethora of fighting types. OU is abundant with fighting types, right? Keldeo, Como, Hawlucha, Mega Medicham, like the list is Megalopony, right? The list goes on, right? And it has a bunch of Pokemon that actually threaten Snorlax. So Snorlax doesn't have its breaking potential, but if you take a metagame like, for example, RBY, the first metagame, or GSC, the second metagame, Snorlax is one of the kings. It's one of the big four in RBY, and it is probably the undisputed king of GSC, because in that generation, Curse is very scary, just because the power creep isn't as much, right? So that's one of the conditions, right? It either has to be really good at what it does, slash the meta permits it to be that. The other condition is that a Pokemon has to have a great secondary effect, right? Or a great secondary type. It doesn't have to be, you know, a fantastic special wall or whatever, right? Lopunny, for instance, Lopunny is a really good normal type in the OU tier. I'm discussing this because this really goes into what I'm talking about with this Pokemon, but Lopunny is a really good normal type because it is part fighting, right? Normal is a good stab, and the things that normal doesn't actually hit, right? Steel, Rock, Ghost, or in this case, the Lopunny obviously has, Mega Lopunny obviously has Scrappy. Fighting helps a breakthrough. So Lopunny is fast, it has great offensive presence, and it has the great secondary stab. Another Pokemon with great secondary stab that is a normal type is Diggersby, right? Ground covers the Rock, the Steel that resists the normal, and some ghost types as long as they don't have levitate, and then it has normal, and obviously couple that with their great move pools, right? So assuming this Pokemon stays fully normal, in order for it to actually be good, it needs to have either a great defensive presence, which does work because it does have access to Fluffy, but Fluffy does not mean that you have to be a defensive tank, and this is where we look at Beware, right? Beware has a nice attack stat, a great HP stat, and a pretty respectable defense stat. Couple that with Fluffy, it's really tough to take it down with a physical contact move just because of that ability. But it's not great at what it does because the metagame doesn't permit it, right? Why use Beware in OU when I can use the fast Megalopony, which is more than likely to get off its attacks, has fake out priority and whatnot too. But when I think about the sheep, I'm thinking in terms that it actually is gonna evolve, right? Into like some sort of ram, right? Because it has little horns right here, so I'm hoping that its evolution is a little bit more offensive. Because when you think of normal types with Fluffy, or even Fur Coat, because I think of Fur Coat when I see this. I think of Furfro, and unfortunately Furfro is not the greatest of Pokemon. It can tank a Mega Lucario's close combat, and what is it doing back? Like, it's not really going to be able to do much back, right? Maybe like a Thunder Wave or something like that. So, in order for this Pokemon to be good on the defensive side, it needs to have good support moves, and I'm talking support moves in terms of, obviously, status, like Thunder Wave. Which is fair because it is a normal type Pokemon, so that is definitely something it could potentially have. Another one is U-turn for momentum. That's great. Heal Bell is another big one, and I think of Heal Bell when I think of, like, you know, Ampharos, and you know how Ampharos was like in Gold and Silver, and how it was the literal like lighthouse and bell and things like that too. It's not really a bell, it's a light, but Heal Bell is something they could have. And I think reliable recovery, and that's asking for a lot, right? But that's how you make this Pokemon great. It needs to have some sort of there basically needs to be a reason or a niche to use it over a different wall, right? And the normal wall that comes to mind is Chansey, right? There's very few OU Pokemon with normal typing. It's literally Chansey and Lopunny, right? Diggersby is BL, and so is Staraptor, so I guess and Porygon as well, but they have things going for them in terms of ability. Staraptor obviously has Reckless, and it's not its normal stab that makes it threatening, but it's the fact that it can click Brave Bird. It can literally Brave Bird everything, and close combat plus U-turn for momentum. So if this Pokemon does evolve, and we want it to be good offensively, it can stay pure normal, but it needs to have the coverage as well, right? So I'm thinking, like, for example, there are some pure normal types that are just really good. I already named Porygon. Chansey's great defensively, but one that comes to mind that is actually really, really good is Mega Kangaskhan. But why? Mega Kangaskhan has a Parental Bond ability, has Fake Out Priority, Power Up Punch, Seismic Toss as well as a 2-hit KO on literally everything, Sucker Punch Priority as well, Earthquake. So if we want Wooloo to be good, whatever ram that I'm hoping it evolves into, I honestly think it has to take a more offensive presence, because a defensive normal type, it's gonna have a lot of competition in terms of like Chansey. And I don't think there's gonna be anything where, unless they nerf a Violite slash get rid of it, I don't think that Chansey is not leaving the OU. I think that Chansey's gonna stay in the OU tier, right? It's not leaving the OU tier anytime soon. So obviously the tiers are gonna shift when new Pokemon come out, but I think that good Pokemon will always be good. Heatran, Landorus and whatnot. So if you wanna be a defensive Pokemon, I don't think that that's gonna help Wooloo out. And again, a lot of this is theory, man, and I might be repeating myself. I do apologize. Maybe I'll script the next one or at least write down what I want to talk about. But if it wants to be a great offensive Pokemon, I think that Fluffy is okay with that, right? I think that Fluffy still works on an offensive tank, because that's what it literally has to be. But it has to have the attack stat. It has to have a high attack stat, obviously, and it has to have the coverage. And when I talk about coverage, if it's a normal type, it needs to have ground coverage or ground or fighting. Those are pretty much a given. In order for a normal type to be great offensively, it needs to have ground or fighting coverage next to it. Why? Because that literally lets you, I don't know, I just didn't put superpower, but it has to have one of these two moves, right? Or superpower or whatever. Because that literally lets you get through one of your weaknesses, right? That's a big thing. Because it is a normal type though, I don't think it's gonna have a terrible move pool. But if you look at Furfro, for instance, Furfro really doesn't have anything going for it besides its base speed, right? So like defensively, like it has a good special move pool, quote unquote, good special move pool, but it also has base 65 special attack. And it's its own singular Pokemon, right? I just think at the current time, this Pokemon legitimately has to evolve in order to be good. But from a sheep, it evolves into a ram is what I'm hoping. And a nice offensive Pokemon that can maybe click like Choice Band Double Edge, Choice Band Outrage, just been outrage, excuse me, no, Choice Band Superpower, Choice Band Earthquake, and because it is a sheep, or it becomes a ram, or whatever, I'm hoping that Milk Drink might be in its arsenal. Maybe if it's bred with, like, assuming it's able to be bred with, like, something like Skiddo, for instance, which I always believed was, like, I think this Pokemon should have been part normal, but having access to Milk Drink, bulk up options as well, like, if you want this Pokemon to be good, has to not only have the stats for it, but has to have the coverage, and that's just basic for a specific Pokemon, but for this normal type in particular, it literally needs to have ground or fighting coverage to be good on the offensive side, and I think that there is very little for it to be great in on defensively, right? Fluffy's a naturally a good defensive ability, but if you don't have, why would I use this, you know, when I can use this? And that's saying a lot. That's not saying a lot because Chansey is the premier special wall. But as far as physical walls go, normal doesn't check enough in the tier, right? Normal doesn't have resistances besides the immunity to ghosts, and it is immune, and ghost is immune to normal as well, so they share that. And obviously it only has one weakness though, so like it's a good typing, but defensive wise it needs reliable recovery, and honestly a good HP stat as well. I think that's the best thing. But as far as the sheep goes, I do think that its best chance is having an offensive evolution that again is a ram. I've said that multiple times. And that ram has ground coverage or fighting coverage. And honestly, even momentum and U-turn would do a lot. It'd go a long way for it. But my overall verdict of this Pokemon before even seeing anything about its final evolution is just because it faces such competition being a normal type from already good normal types, I don't think we'd ever see a Pokemon like this in OU. Now, you can quote me on that when it actually comes out. And a lot of this is theory modding and whatnot, but I'm thinking about based on what we know already, I don't think we see a Pokemon in this in OU. Like, for example, Beware. Beware's a great Pokemon. Staraptor's a great Pokemon, right? But why use one of them as a normal offensive type when I can use Lopunny for its speed tier? Why use a defensive normal type when I can use Chansey, one of the best premier, you know, special walls? So if this Pokemon wants to be at least good, I think offense is the best thing going for it. Like, even if you look at the UU tiers, there is very little, if any, and obviously tiers are going to shift, but I don't see any like normal wall at all, like, down here. So I really think, besides Blissey, obviously, and then, even then it'd be facing competition for Blissey itself. But yeah, it'd be like a physical wall at that. So that's my overall thoughts on Wooloo. Obviously, I do acknowledge that this video is probably all over the place, but let me know your thoughts as well on this Pokemon. What do you think it needs to be better in competitive? And I'll make this video for other Pokemon as well. I think normal typing is really hard to talk about. I really do, personally. That's why I wanted to start with this Pokemon. But let me know your thoughts. I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye, my friends.